So today I'm going to give an interview in Cape Germany. Okay. So I'm recording this so that that might help for other. So let's see how my interview goes. And please comment that what should I do to improve myself or how this interview session had improved you. So let's wait for the interviewer to come and then I will resume this. If you like this video, please subscribe my channel. Thank you. So if you see that they have given me a link of Microsoft Teams, okay? So I clicked on join session. Then I use Edge browser to start the meeting. And now my meeting is getting start. Yeah. So my meeting are getting start, my interview are getting start. Okay. So let's see. Since it took my IBM ID, so I'm using some other ID. So I enter the meeting. So let's wait for the panelists. So I'm waiting for panelists to join. So only I am there. Yeah, panelists join. Yeah, hi Gitanjali.
Can you adjust your camera?
Okay, okay. Is it fine now?
Sorry?
Voter ID will work, right?
Yes. Can you change
some voter ID?
It
should be working. It's not clear. Can you take towards
you? No. It's
still
blurry.
Okay, PAN card will work?
Yeah, that will also work.
Okay, actually it's a white thing, so that might be...
So we'll start with your interview process. Can you tell me something about yourself?
Okay, my name is Firdaus Alam. I have total 8 years of IT industry experience. As a software developer, I have gained knowledge on different technology, starting from web application to mobile application. And right now I'm working as in API service using microservices. Currently I am working with IBM for past 4.4 years. And my role in IBM is module lead. Coming to my project, my current project name is BlueCat. which is an IBM advisory tool. I have been working in this project for past 4 years. My role in this project is to be a Node.js module lead. And for past 1.5 years, I have successfully converted our application, which was on monolithic application, which was on monolithic architecture, to microservice one. So this is that's it. So these are about myself.
Mentioned about microservices, can you explain me about microservices in Node.js?
Okay, so microservices mean you will divide your application, I would say a monolithic application, into a different services, so that each and every services can run indivisibly. I mean, they depend upon one another, but if there are problem in one service, that do not harm the whole application. So it's a way of breaking your whole application into different services which can work standalone. Yeah, re-eval print loop. I mean that allow us to write some Node.js command in command line, through command line.
Okay. Have you worked with it?
No, I haven't got an opportunity to work with it.
Okay, so you just heard about it?
Yeah, I just heard about it.
Used in Node.js?
Data type. Data type, can you tell me more? Like
data types in Node.js, I mean.
Okay, object, you're talking about object, array, string, int, right? Yeah, okay. I mean, since you know that since we know that JavaScript is a loosely typed language, so we can hold different kind of data into same variable, like primitive type or non-primitive type. So all we can store on a same variable.
Okay. Basically, you tell me first about what is Node.js. The purpose of it, how it differs from JavaScript, all those
stuff. Okay, so Node.js provide a runtime environment which allow us to run a JavaScript code on a server. So it's basically an environment, okay, which allow us to write a JavaScript code on server. So a basic difference between a JavaScript and a Node.js is that JavaScript will get compiled only on browser, but if we wrap a JavaScript with a Node.js environment, then we can run that code in a server, or we can say the backend. Okay. I was knowing that, but it's not coming in my mind. Okay.
Is it a single thread, multi-thread? How it works?
Okay. Understood. So, Node.js. I would say process model is Node.js run on single thread. Okay. So what it does? Whenever a request come to Node.js, it catch those requests, and then it pass those requests to the event loop, and when that process get completed, okay, and it does not wait, and it does not wait for the process to get complete. It put those requests in an event loop and wait for it callback. So when any process get complete, it call back to the event loop, and again from event loop that response get call back to the I would say client or client or and it give response back to the client.
Okay, so as you have mentioned about creating the server with Node.js, can you explain me with a simple process, like if I wanted to write a hello world simply onto a server, how will you create a simple server with Node.js?
Okay, when we generally use Express, so I have to include Express module in our application by installing npm install Express. But first of all, we have to install npm in our machine or in our server. Then we have to install Express, and then we have to include Express in our in our server page. Then we have to include Express function. Like for example, can I show you one example? Okay. Or by word it will be fine.
Sorry.
Okay, I am continuing. Okay, so we have to include a Express module, and then we have to create one Express function, and then we have to listen in some port by using app.listen callback function, and then we can give some console. So with this, we can run a Node.js server. With the framework Express, what it does, it open one port. Okay, it open one port which we define there, and then it's work. So whenever we are writing any Node.js code, it has been advised to whenever we are using any callback, then it has been advised or it is a best practice to handle the error first. Okay, if any response are coming from any callback, then the first parameter should be an error, and second parameter may be data or anything. So that's the a programmatical structure we should follow, that whenever any callback are happening, then first parameter should be our error, and so this is error callback first.
Okay.
Okay,
and what is then callback help?
Okay, see, when we are writing a code, there come a situation that we use a multiple callback. Okay, we within a process or within a API. So what happened? Our code structure goes in a horizontal way. It becomes so long in a horizontal way that it becomes unreadable. So this situation where we use a multiple callback and our callback become such a huge, that it we cannot read it properly. So this situation are called as an error callback help. Sorry, callback help.
Okay. Fine. Can you give me one example of callback help?
Yeah, suppose.
Real time example.
Yeah, suppose there are 10 one process need to update 10-12 DB. Okay, 10-12 DB tables. So and one table are depending upon the others. So what a coder does in order to make it synchronously, so they write all the code in a callback, so that once a insertion done on one table, then only it goes to the second function where it inserted data on second table, and in this way it goes on. So in that process, there may come a situation that your quote become a very lengthy one, horizontally, not vertically, but horizontally, and it become unreadable. Okay.
So, what is the method which Node.js is used on?
Yeah, Node.js by default work asynchronously. It means that it does not wait for other processes to get complete. When there is any process which take some time, like a DB call or file read and write, so it does not wait for that process to get complete. It goes to the below line. And once that process get complete, then it start it work. So this is example of synchronous behavior. And to work Node.js asynchronously, there are many modules which allow us to like first read the data from the file, or read the data from the table and do your processes. So to work Node.js asynchronously, there are many modules which help us. Like async await, promise. So by using those modules, we can stop Node.js to work it asynchronously and make it synchronized way. What is stub? Actually, I haven't worked on this, so I don't know. I don't know stub.
Okay. Can you explain the promises?
Yeah. As I told you earlier, that Node.js by default works synchronously. To work it asynchronously, we can use promise. Promise, you can say, it whenever we call any function, then once that function get complete, whether it's at a DB call or a file read and write, then only by using a then function, then only its callback function will work. Okay, so promise you can say it's a way of working Node.js asynchronously. So that's it. I know about Capgemini. Okay, I know. It's a very renowned company, so I know about him. I do not have any such question here. Okay, because I know everything about the Capgemini. Many of my friends work here, so I know a lot of this company. Okay.
Sorry.
I know everything about Capgemini, so I do not have any question. Okay, right now.
Nice meeting you. I'll drop my feedback with HR and
they'll
get back to you.
Yeah, okay, Gitanjali. Same here.
Thank you.
Yeah, thank
Bye-bye.
You. Bye-bye. So this was my interview with the Capgemini. Actually, I'm not feeling well. I'm having fever. Still, today I have given this interview simply because the interviewer called me and told that just give the interview. So I just given the interview. I know that there were many flaws in this interview. My head is paining very badly, so I could not able to explain him as I have to explain. So let's see whether I got selected or not. Because I am having fever, you can see my face, I am having fever, and cough and cold, so I could not able to give interview in such a way. So I will post you that whether I get selected with this condition or not. Thank you for watching this video, and if you like this video, please subscribe my channel. I think I have posted some other videos also regarding interview. So let's see that what happened in the end, which company I landed in the end. Okay, thanks for joining, and thank you.